Hey guys, welcome back to GP Reactions. I hope you're well. Hope you've been having a great weekend. It's now Monday evening, and I'm really, really glad to be back. I can't remember last time I did in reactions, but I was like really, really poorly, and yeah, it's just good to be back. I'm not going to really harp on about it too much. I hate being ill, and I hate that I can't do things that I would enjoy because I haven't got the energy. I'm still a bit sort of like breathy now and a bit, my throat and my neck's still a bit tight. So, but it's really, really good to be back. And so here we are. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for commenting. Thank you for helping me out and buying me a coffee. That's a really, really cool way of appreciating anything I do. And it means such a lot to me as well. So this is a track I am going to keep getting into. I work in a library, so this is quite appropriate. Maybe not. And this is a track by XTC, and it's taken from their 1992 album, Nonesuch. The track is called Books Are Burning. XTC are Andy Partridge on vocals and guitar. We have Colin Moulding on bass and guitars, Dave Gregory on guitars and synths. And this is a live performance from The Late Show on BBC. Now, my knowledge of XTC was that the only thing I can remember about XTC, reading up on it, was that Andy Partridge wasn't that keen on live performances. So this must be a rarity, I'm guessing. So, yeah, I'm really looking forward to getting to this. This is the last track on the album, I think, and and yeah, so this is a live performance, and let's click play and see what this one's about. Never disappointed with an XTC track, because there's also something interesting going on in the music or the lyrics.
In the late 70s, XTC were at the forefront of the British New Wave, mixing their abrasive, quirky sound with an obvious melodic debt to the Beatles. Although they've continued to release albums, enjoy cult status in the US, and score the occasional hit in Britain, they haven't played live for 10 years. Well, XTC have just released their 10th album, Nonesuch, and The Late Show coaxed them out of semi-retirement to play live again. Here they are with Burning Books. From me, good night.
Good night. Pause it down. I can say that back because it seems to be it's not buffering, but it just seems to be not really okay. Let's just take a bit back a bit. So my apologies if there's any bit of, like, start stopping of this.
Smell.
song is making me think of maybe, I was thinking of, is it Nazi Germany where they were burning books? And yeah, I just saw it really sinister about the one line where it says, a smell of burnt book is not unlike human hair. And I was wondering whether this was a, I don't know, nod to like fascism or Nazi Germany or, because I remember they did some unspeakable things to people as well as books during that time. And yeah, that's my initial thoughts on it so far. I really like how mellow this track is. It's really laid back. But, you know, that was always like for me listening to XTC, that they settle you with music or but with unsettling lyrics. But settling music or it's the other way around. And you never really quite know. You're always wrong-footed by then and their sound. So, yeah, this is another really, really great track. Really great guitar. Sorry about the visuals, by the way. That was really, really good. That was XTC, Books Are Burning, and that was taken from the album Nonsuch. And that was a really good live performance. Again, as I always, you know, ask, is this similar to their studio performance, their studio version? Just loved Andy Partridge's vocals, especially that guitar at the end. I mean, I you know, I've listened to a few XTC songs, but I've never really kind of like thought of, you know, that, you know, being a really, really good guitarist. I don't know why. It's just always about his vocals, his performance, and the sound of his voice. But this was really, really good. I love the way it kind of built towards the end, but it was really, really mellow. But that guitar at the end was just fantastic. Absolutely loved that. Books Are Burning. I mean, this is my initial thoughts halfway through was that this had some sort of historical context. It could be a generalization about how we maybe don't look after, I don't know, literature or something, or like when I say don't look after literature, we are maybe diverted by more frivolous things. So No, back in 92, they didn't have internet really as such. So maybe it's all about just the social media of the day was like television, I guess. And I don't know, I'm just thinking maybe this is like a diversion away from literature and just kind of books basically, but sort of like dumbing down maybe of society. Maybe that's what it's about. Anyway, I'll read the lyrics and see if anything else jumps out at me. Books are burning in the main square. I mean, that for a start off, that just makes me think of Hitler and his bunch of cronies burning the books of people. And I saw there the fire eating the text. Books are burning in the still air. You know where they burn books. People are next. I believe the printed word should be forgiven. Doesn't matter what it said. Wisdom hotline from the dead back to the living. Key to the larder for your heart and your head. I love that line. Key to the larder for your heart and your head. Books are burning in our own town. Watch us turn around, cast our glances elsewhere. So we're kind of like ignoring it and we're sort of turning a blind eye. But it feels like we're aware of it, aware that it's maybe not good, but you have to go with the majority, I guess, or those that could do you harm if you show any dissent. Books are burning in the playground. Smell of a burnt book is not unlike human hair. That's really sinister line, but yeah, a really, really good line as well. Well, I believe the printed word is more than sacred. Beyond the gauge of food or good or bad, the human right to let your soul fly free and naked above the violence of the fearful and sad. The Church of Matches anoints in ignorance with gasoline. The Church of Matches grows fat by breathing in the smoke of dreams. It's quite obscene. Books are burning more each day now. And I pray now you boys will tire of these games. Books are burning, I hope somehow, but this will allow a phoenix up in flames. Yeah, I mean, having read these lyrics, I would pretty much put money on that. It is about that period of history where books were burned, and I'm thinking of Nazi Germany and stuff like that. But it's a really, really good song, and I just loved his demeanour right the way through the song. I loved the way it built, and the bass was really nice as well. It was very, I can't even explain it. I could hear it in my headphones on the one sort of like just at the back. It was just a really, really cool accompaniment for the song. Yeah, this is really, really good. I enjoyed this. I've never seemed to be disappointed with XTC. There are people there who kind of know all the XTC songs, and it's understandable that people would be big fans of this band back in the day, and even now more so, for a track like that, it still has a resonance. How many years? 32 years on. You could sort of still think about it in historical terms of what it means, and a great delivery as well by Andy Partridge. You know, he's not just fluffing about there. You know that he's thinking about what he's singing and how he's singing it. It's written by and it was written by Andy Partridge as well. So before my voice finally kind of gives up on me, please join me in the comments below and let me know what you feel about his song. And also, you know, I'm always open for any other XTC songs that you might have in your mind for me to listen to if I haven't already heard them. So yeah, till next time, take care of yourselves, have a wonderful week, and I'll speak to you all later.